The connectivity analyses you did in the previous chapters were done in what is called volumetric space. Each image has individual voxels acquired with a specific length, width, and height, and the time series is averaged across groups of voxels within each region. However, the preprocessing step of smoothing can average signal across functionally heterogeneous areas, which can be especially problematic for connectivity analysis. For example, the ridges of two nearby gyri can be a few millimeters away from each other when viewed from above, even though the actual distance from peak to peak can be many times longer than that. This distance is more accurately represented by reconstructing the image into surface space, which can both increase power and reduce the chance of smoothing across different regions or tissue types. The best way to reconstruct a surface is with FreeSurfer, and the rest of this video assumes you already have it installed and know how to use it. You can find a walkthrough in the link down below. For the remainder of this tutorial, we will use the first three subjects of the arithmetic task on openneuro.org, which can be found here and in a link down below. If you follow the steps in the previous chapters, you should have the entire dataset downloaded. Use a terminal to navigate to the folder arithmetic, which in my case is in my desktop directory. Make sure you are in a bash shell, and then type the following code, which you can copy and paste from the more info box down below. This will run recon-all sequentially in each anat directory. More efficient ways of doing this can be found in the links to the chapters down below, but this will work for most people. We will fade out and return when it finishes, which could take several hours or maybe even a day. When recon-all finishes, you will have a new directory within each subject's anat folder. Each of these FreeSurfer directories will contain subfolders such as MRI and Surf, which you will need to import the surface data into CONN. First, open a MATLAB terminal and open the CONN toolbox. Create a new project by clicking on the New button, and let's call this project arithmetic underscore surface. And I'll save this to the arithmetic directory as well. Once you click Save, this will open the Setup tab. Enter 3 for the number of subjects, and change the TR to 3.56. Next, click on the Structural button. Within the FreeSurfer output directories we just created, there's a file called t1.mgz in the MRI subfolder. In the Find field, type t1.mgz, and then press the Find button. Assuming you're in the directory containing all of your subjects, you should see a list of files like this. Scroll down, then shift and highlight all of your subjects in the structural data window, and then hold Control and click to just select the T1 images for the corresponding subjects in their MRI directories and click Import. This will automatically detect, as well, the surface reconstructed anatomical file, along with any segmentation files. If the aseg.mgz files are loaded, you can then skip the segmentation step during preprocessing that we'll talk about later. For now, take a brief look at the reconstructed surfaces for each subject. The functional data, by contrast, is still in volumetric space. During preprocessing, it will be resampled to surface space. Click on Functional. Similar to what we just did above, enter task-rest_bold.nai.gz in the Find field, and then click Find. Highlight the three subjects in the functional data window, and then Control and click to select their corresponding functional files. You can view these imported functional files, just like you did during the volumetric analysis. They should look the same. Even though the CONN toolbox doesn't have a FreeSurfer atlas that comes with it, we can load it in the ROIs button. Click on ROIs, and then hover your cursor over the ROIs window, and click the New button at the bottom of the window. Let's call the new ROI FS underscore Atlas. And in the find field, type lh.apark.anat. Or you could just go to sub1 anat, the FS average link label, and then select lh.apark.anat for annotations. It doesn't matter whether we use the left hemisphere or the right hemisphere, the ROIs for both will be loaded automatically. And you can see this set of regions in this window over here. Now click on Options and change the analysis base to Surface Same as Template. I'm also going to uncheck Dynamic Circuits and Voxel to Voxel just to save time. And in preprocessing, we'll select the default surface-based analysis pipeline. I'm going to remove segmentation since we already imported the segmentations from FreeSurfer, and also slice time and correction because I'm not sure exactly what the slice timing order was. Click Start and select the defaults when prompted, and preprocessing will take a few minutes. When the preprocessing finishes, go back to the ROIs section and click on FS Atlas. Under Compute Average Time Series, select from Secondary Dataset number 4, Surface Space Data. This will use the average time series from the resampled gray matter on the surface instead of the volumetric data. You can also take a brief look at the functional datasets now that it's been resampled to the surface. You can view it from different angles as well. When you have finished all this, click the Done button to run the setup pipeline. I'm going to fade out and come back when it finishes. The Denoising tab will be the same as it was during the volumetric functional connectivity analysis and the interpretation of the connectivity distributions and principal components analysis is the same. The only difference is that you will see the bold variance projected onto a surface for each subject instead of their volume. Now click on Done to proceed to the first level analysis tab. The first level analysis will also be very similar to the volumetric analysis, except that this time the results are projected onto a cortical surface. To save time for the group level analysis, we will remove all of the selected seeds and sources except for the first three ROIs listed in the FS Atlas that we specified in the Setup tab. Click Done to proceed to the group level analysis. Once the first level results are done, you can highlight any of the regions and click the Compute or Display Results button. I've already done this for a couple of these regions, and you can see it displayed on the surface template on the right. I'm going to load existing analysis results for the caudal anterior cingulate. Just like with the volumetric analysis, you see a glass brain with significant clusters and a corresponding table underneath. If you click on the Surface Display button, the first one in the upper left corner of the buttons under Display and Print, you can more accurately see the connectivity results displayed on the surface of the cortex. Here, I'm going to change the color bar limits so that we can get a better sense of where there are increases and decreases in connectivity. And you can rotate the brain as you like and also restrict it to just one of the hemispheres. All of the other options for volumetric-based analysis, including independent samples tests, adding covariates, and ROI to ROI analyses, are the same in this case as well. The only difference being that the results are displayed on the surface. See the previous chapters for a walkthrough on how to run these other analyses.